Hi guys and welcome to our channel. So over to Kyle, what are you cooking today?
Today I'm doing my rendition of Hunter's Chicken. Basic home style stuff that we can buy in the supermarket by using little and less ingredients as possible. So we're going to get started in a moment. If you'd like to see, I'll set up the ingredients of what we're using today. We have a basic dish to put all the chicken in. We have bacon, Dutch style bacon.
What do you do with the bacon?
You wrap it around it, it tastes really nice. Smoky goes well. I wouldn't recommend unsmoked because it gives you that extra zing, the flavour that goes well with the barbecue
more
sauce.
More flavour.
Okay, more flavour the better. Okay, now we have black pepper.
Yeah.
Garlic granules. Mixed herbs. Now this is something new I'm going to try today. This is
Trust you.
and we have some golden vegetable rice to go on the side and some steamed corn on the cobs that we did the other day. We saved it. Mm-hmm. We're just going to reheat it. They're really delicious. Okay.
Right, so away we go then.
Okay, what I'm doing now... I'm
going to focus down on the pan more than...
I'm laying the chicken into our dish at the moment.
Okay.
I'm then going to... But it's simple. We're using rich and smoky barbecue sauce because it goes well with the smoky bacon. It's the term smoky.
We usually get an actual Hunter's Chicken actual jar sauce, but we couldn't find one this month when doing shopping, so just decided to do the barbecue sauce.
As I'm going, I'm just going to coat it as much as I can in the barbecue sauce.
Okay.
Put some herbs in it as well.
What's that you've got there? Is that black
this
pepper?
Is black pepper.
Yeah.
Obviously, I don't want too much.
Yeah.
You want a smidgen, not too much, of garlic granules.
Okay, so that's garlic granules you've got there.
Yeah.
Just sprinkling those on top. I'll get
sprinkle
a bit closer.
All around.
Oh, that's looking really nice.
Yep. And this is something a bit different. Some mixed herbs.
You say this is a bit of like an experiment.
This one is an experiment.
Okay. I'm sure it'll taste good anyway.
Okay, so that's all mixed in. Now, what you want to do is get stuck in. Just mix it all around.
Don't be shy, guys. Mix it all in. It'll be good. Trust me. There we go.
So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly just put some more sauce on the chicken.
Mm-hmm. So you're just recoating it?
Yeah, I'm just recoating it because it seems to run off after a while. Now I've done that.
Okay.
I'll take this one out.
Yep.
Place it on the board. Sorry, I've just actually got some barbecue sauce on this. I actually split it. But anyway, just wrap the chicken in the bacon. Because this bacon strip is split in half, I'll stick another one round it.
It happens, doesn't it?
Yeah. Like so.
That's the thing about cooking, it's always a bit on the fly, isn't it? If something goes a bit pear-shaped, you always have to try and make the best of a bad situation sort of thing, don't you?
Okay.
So
that's what it should look like
before
that. It goes back in there.
And that goes
back
in the dish.
Now that's back in there. We do it with the same all other bits of chicken.
Okay, so you continue to wrap them all in bacon.
Yeah, continue to wrap them all in bacon.
Okay. What I'm going to do then, guys, is I'm going to let Kyle carry on wrapping the chicken over the bacon. And we'll be back in a minute. Okay, so you've told me what you've done.
Basically, I've wrapped it all in bacon.
Mm-hmm.
And now what I'm going to do... just put more barbecue sauce on.
Okay, so you're just going to coat over the top of the
yes,
bacon.
Totally.
Okay.
Like so. You want to make it as saucy as possible. When you put it in the oven, you want to make it bubbly.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now.
So,
now we've
got
our water.
Okay,
just
so you
pour it over.
Just going to sprinkle it over the top. And that's going to help to cook the chicken, sort of almost steam it.
Yeah, well, it's going to steam it a lot. I'm going to take it around. I'm not going to rub it through because it looks like it's going to bubble up as it is. Now, I have some mild cheddar cheese here. I don't like using mature when grating because it just breaks off into big chunks.
It gets too crumbly.
It does really get crumbly. Mm-hmm. And it's actually really, really soft.
Yeah, that cheese is really nice.
And it smells beautiful.
Yeah, really good. Really does.
Now I'm going to grate the cheese on top.
Okay.
Right, we don't like too much cheese on there. Now you see the result before it goes into the oven.
Okay.
We're going to set the oven down.
Okay.
Okay, I'm preheating the oven. Mm-hmm. 5 minutes on 180.
Okay.
Okay. Once that's preheated, we'll whack it in on 160 for 30 to 45 minutes. Okay, and what, guys, right now, what I'm going to do is put it in the oven. Okay.
Whoa, that is a hot oven. You should really wear oven gloves when doing that step, but Kyle is being a beast and...
Asbestos hands, I don't feel the heat. Okay, now I'm setting the oven for 45 minutes.
Yep, so setting the timer.
Setting the timer for 45 minutes and I'm going to take the temperature down to 160. We got this golden vegetable savoury rice. What I'm doing now is boiling up some water to put into a jug. You need 825 mils of hot water. It's come straight out of the kettle. It's easier for you to boil rice quicker and efficiently. What I'm going to do is pour this into the rice.
How many packets did you use?
I used 2 packets because we're doing for 2.5 people.
Yeah, and if you're unsure, just follow the packet mix as instructed on the packet.
Yeah, it gives you a microwave and a sauce warmer. We're doing it from the sauce warmer.
I didn't know you could do it in the microwave.
You can.
Ah,
you can.
That's cool.
Quite efficient. Sits here.
So we've got the rice in the pan here, and that's all ready to go, looking quite nice, yeah. So what do we do now? Do we just add the water to the rice?
Yeah, we add the water to the rice and I'll...
Okay, so that's the first load of water added. What we'll do is we'll jump cut and hopefully the rice should be on the boil by then. So see you in a minute.
Okay, right, now we've put all the water into the pan with the rice. We're just letting it steam up now.
Letting it do its thing.
It should initially be done within 15 minutes of it being on high temperature of 9 on our hot, because that's the highest it will go up to. Now, while all that's doing that, I am going to reheat our corn on the cob. I won't do it initially straight away.
Over here, there we go.
Yeah, we're going to put corn on the cobs into our seafood dish with some water, and I'm going to steam them again, add a little bit more salt.
Yeah.
Not too much, because obviously they had salt on there the other day.
Yep.
Okay. I won't do that straight away because I want to do it all together to make it sure it comes out at the same time. Okay, so we'll finish boiling the rice.
So that's all done then, yeah?
Yeah, it's just finished. It's been on for 15 minutes on high temperature.
Yep.
Hot. Now it's all really fluffy.
Looks
just
delicious.
Mix it all together. Honestly, if you can smell this.
If it was smell-o-vision.
Smell-o-vision. Is that even a thing?
No, it's not.
Wish it was.
Oh, it'd be so good.
Made me hungry constantly. The amount of adverts they put on the TV.
Oh, I know, right?
Okay, now that's done. We've got another 17 minutes on the chicken and bacon.
Yeah, but it's looking great. See if I can get a view. Look at that. You can see the bubbling cheese. Yeah, the reflection's not all that great because it looks like a lot of the reflection's hitting back. But that looks absolutely gorgeous. So
it doesn't really matter if the rice is hot or cold. It's going to taste really nice either way.
Yeah, we've had that cold before as well, haven't we? And it's delicious as well.
Nice. Get this corn on the cob set up and ready.
Yeah.
It's going to take about a good 5 minutes to steam up in my pan.
Okay.
What I've done So I filled up a jug all the way through. It's about 600 mils.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just over half a litre of water.
Okay, so I'm going to put that in there. So that's just to sort of rehydrate them, yeah?
Rehydrate. I don't think it's
going to
fit
all in. That's fine. No, that's fine. They should just naturally steam all together anyway, so...
Okay.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to put it in the microwave.
Mm-hmm.
Just over here.
Okay, I'll just turn the camera around.
Okay. I've got it in the microwave. Just need to set the power level.
Okay.
Just on max, that's fine. Time. 5 minutes.
So. Okay, so that's now in the microwave.
Yeah, it's boiling up for 5 minutes. So I'm going to stop it halfway through, put some salt on,
yep.
Put it back in, whack it on. By that point, hopefully...
Everything should be done. Okay, so shall we say we'll see you when we're dishing up, yeah? Okie dokie.
Sweet. So, see you shortly.
Peace out. Oh my gosh, you guys, look at this food. Look at that. That is gorgeous. Okay, Kyle, so introduce your dish.
This is my rendition.
Rendition, yeah.
Rendition of Hunter's chicken.
Oh, that looks delicious.
Okay.
Oh, can you see how crispy the bacon is on there? Liz got the like slight flecks of cheese on top and the chicken breast. I bet that's going to be so delicious and so juicy. Can't wait to tuck into this. It's going to be really nice in there.
He's a little man, so he's got tiny pieces.
Little man, he's got his little Finding Nemo plate, which is really cute. Excuse your fingers, I have washed them, so.
Some sauce on this one, so it's a bit watery. But I'll get a spoon. Just so it don't dry out while it's...
Okay, so you're putting the juice on top of the...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Juice on top of each one.
That's basically what it's been cooking in, isn't it?
Yeah.
Just like with the water that we added. That's almost like the cooking liquor, isn't it? That's come out of it.
And I'm going to put some on my rice.
That's
going to
be gorgeous.
Would you like some on your rice?
No, that's fine.
Okay, now that's done. We have our corn on the cobs here, which
they've just been reheated, haven't they?
Reheated in the microwave for about 15 minutes. I added some more salt.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to set them out on each plate. Okay guys, that was my rendition of Hunter's Chicken. I hope you enjoyed the video and I hope to see you next time for when I do another dish.
Okay, one last look at the food. Absolutely gorgeous. Okay, so bye guys, see you in the next video.